Hello, my name is Nydia Tisdale. I live in Roswell, Georgia. I addressed the board last week during the millage rate public hearing held at 6 p.m. I would like to add additional comment to clarify and to correct statements I made during that speech. The board passed a resolution granting the tax commissioner authority to waive interest and penalties on tardy tax payments retroactively to December 31st, 2005, because waivers have been granted for the past 5.5 years while the tax commissioner had no authority to do so. I would like to suggest the following regarding waivers. Waivers should not be granted to taxpayers who do not request waivers. Waivers should not be granted to taxpayers who can afford to pay interest and penalties without undue hardship. If a waiver is granted, the amount of the waiver should be included on the property tax statement. An employee in the tax commissioner's office where payments may be made explained to me that in order to process delinquent payments, when a waiver is granted, the due date must be altered or the computer will not accept the payment. The tax commissioner has authority to grant waivers. However, I do not know if the tax commissioner has authority to alter the due date on a tax bill. This accounting practice is misleading and confusing. The computer code should be updated to allow the amount of a waiver to be reflected on the property tax statement and become a part of the public record. Secondly, I would like to correct statements I made regarding the conservation use assessment for agricultural property. I stated that to qualify, a property must be a minimum of 10 acres. That is incorrect. A property must be a minimum of 2 acres. If a property is more than 2 acres but less than 10 acres, then documentation must be provided to support the agricultural use. In return for the favorable tax treatment, the property owner must keep the land undeveloped in a qualifying use for a period of 10 years or incur stiff penalties. During the 10-year period, if any of the property is sold or changes in use, a breach may occur. Owners who breach their conservation use covenant must pay back to the taxing authorities twice the savings they have received over the life of the covenant up to the point it was breached. Numerous properties receive the SV exemption that are not properly qualified to receive this tax savings. The tax assessor should review properties receiving the SV exemption. Finally, it has been brought to my attention that it is inappropriate to identify an individual by name. Thus, I will close with the following statement. If anyone was offended by my speech last week, I am sincerely sorry. Thank you.